Hello. Today we are going to make checkered finish line, racing cars, black and white flag. Inflate black and white balloons, leaving about 8-9 inch flat tail. We are going to twist all bubbles soft and of the same size, about 1-1.5 inch. Twist the first two bubbles. Lock all ends of the first two bubbles in one lock twist. In previously published instructions, we use different fabric to make many different kind of flags. As you will see, in this example, we take different approach to make the flag. So here we have made the first two white bubbles. Squeeze the balloon to force the air about 2 inches away from the first two bubbles. I hold three my fingers between the set of first two bubbles and the rest of the balloon. Now we twist the third and the fourth white bubbles. Lock all ends of the last two bubbles in one lock twist. You have to keep the first two bubbles separated from the last two bubbles. Just hold your fingers between first two and last two bubbles while you're twisting the bubbles. That's it. Work the rest of the balloon in the same fashion to make total of 12 bubbles or 6 pairs of bubbles. Squeeze the air and stretch the balloon slightly. Watch my left hand, pinky, ring and middle finger between rest of the balloon and the previous two bubbles. Now we twisted the next two bubbles. Lock all ends of the fifth and the sixth bubble in one lock twist. Put your fingers between last two bubbles and previous two bubbles to separate them when you're working on the lock. In this example, I'm going to use two white and two black balloons, total of 4 balloons, to make the flag. A rectangular shape with sides 4x6 bubbles. The smallest flag we can make using just one white and one black balloon. A rectangular shape with sides 2x4 bubbles. So if you have made 4 pairs of white bubbles, you can stop and make 4 pairs of black bubbles. As I mentioned before, I'm going to use the entire balloon to make total of 6 pairs of bubbles. Oh, I almost forgot it. I want to say thank you to YouTube user name, let me spell it, GBKNIPIFY. Pardon my English here. Thanks for your comment where you mentioned the checkered flag. It was a good puzzle to figure out how to make this flag. I got really good time. And my kid actually using this flag to play roll games, racing cars, of course. And again, many thanks to everyone who leave comments and ask questions. I really appreciate it. Your comments and questions helps me to stay focused on balloon twisting, on few do it projects. These days I spend much less time online than I used to. Nevertheless, I do read all your comments and I try to answer all your questions as soon as I can. Okay, let's get back to our sculpture. Here I finished twisting 6 pair of bubbles. If you stretch the balloon slightly, you will see how much spare space we have between each pair of bubbles. Now let's cut off the rest of the balloon. We can do it with scissors. Then we tie off the end or just hide it between bubbles. We're going to use a spare space between pairs of bubbles to connect different balloons to each other. And we're going to do it in checkered pattern. I fixed all bubbles in the same direction across the long side. Later we're going to change the directions. So again, in this example I use two white and two black balloons, total of 4 balloons. Use each balloon to make 6 pairs of bubbles. Now we have to connect balloons to each other. I will start from top left corner of the flag. A pair of first black bubbles goes in this corner. Directly under it goes a pair of first white bubbles. Use the spare space between pairs of bubbles to connect balloons to each other. The second white pair of bubbles goes on top of the flag. Now we have to attach the second black balloon. Again, we use a spare space between nearest two pairs of bubbles to connect balloons to each other. We have to stretch the spare space between pairs and then just wrap the balloons around each other. At the beginning it may seem a bit hard to do, especially if you have not enough of spare space between pairs. When we attach balloons to each other using spare space, we make the lock. It doesn't have to be exactly at the center of the spare spaces. I make the lock slightly to the left side of the spare space, closer to the first pairs of bubbles. Okay, here I attach the last white balloon. The first column starting from the top goes black, white pairs. All four balloons already placed in order. To make the second column starting from the top, it goes white, black. It is much easier and faster to connect just two balloons to each other. Anyway, let's make the second column. Now we use the spare space between second and third pairs of bubbles to connect balloons to each other. Make sure to follow the checkered pattern. Again, it was black, white in the first column. In the second column it goes white, black. And we have to leave balloons in order for the third column, which is follow the same color order as the first column, black, white. At this moment I don't want to waste my time to fix all bubbles in the same directions. We will do it later. As I mentioned previously, working in this fashion, it is much easier to connect just two balloons to each other than three or more balloons. With two balloons we can make the smallest checkered pattern flag. Rectangular shape with sides 2x4 bubbles. To make larger size sculptures, we can work in the same fashion as we do our sculpture right now. Or we can use flat balloons to make connection between sets of black and white balloons. Each set would consist of two balloons, one black, one white. Make as many sets as you need and then use flat balloons to connect all sets in one piece of fabric. Okay, what else I forgot to say, huh? Size and proportions. According to Wikipedia Racing Cars Flags page, there is no definition of what size or what proportions should be the flag. We can make it any size, any proportions. Just make sure to follow the checkered pattern. In this example we make in a rectangular shape, but it's all up to you. You can make a square or whatever else you like. Okay, it looks like we're getting very close to the finish line here. Indeed, we're fixing the last column of our flag. Now it is time to fix all bubbles pointing in the same direction. It would be the longwise direction. I twisted all bubbles of kind of oval shape. So now I'm going to fix each bubble long side in the same direction as long side of our flag goes. If you want, you can fix it in different direction along short side of a rectangle. It would change the proportions of the flag. In a little while we'll get to the smallest checkered flag. That's where you're going to see how directions of bubbles affects proportions of the flag. So basically we have made the flag already, and it's double-sided, meaning that both sides of the flag look exactly the same. 4x6, there are 24 pairs, 48 bubbles. And here's a finish line flag. Congratulations, we have made it. Let's take a look. Here's a top view, the front view, the side view. Very simple checkered pattern with all its simplicity. It was a real headache to make it for me. Hopefully you will enjoy this work. We can use different colors to make the flag, and we can make different size. That's what I'm going to do now. I'm going to use scissors to cut our flag on two parts. One part will be with sides 2x4 bubbles, and the bigger part will be with sides 4x4 bubbles. Let's fix all bubbles in proper positions, and you will see the difference in proportions of the flags. The part with sides 2x4 is an example of the smallest flag that we can make using just two balloons. The long side of each bubble goes in the same direction as short side of the rectangle in this example. And here's a part with sides 4x4. It is sounds like we have a square, though it's not a square. It is rectangular shape. I don't have time to try different shapes, leave it for you. Think it's possible to make diamond shape or maybe even square. Okay, we made it to the finish line. Congratulations again. Have fun and happy twisting.